Hello. Hi everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everybody. Welcome to the next session of SAP FF1 HANA training. Thank you for choosing Leggy Tutorials. In the last couple of sessions, we have discussed about the concepts of SAP HANA. We discussed about code to data paradigm. We have seen the concepts of in-memory database. And then in the last session only, we have seen the evolution of HANA over SPO and release. We have seen the architecture of SAP HANA. We have seen the index server. Okay. So before. Okay. So now let's start with the Eclipse and HANA Studio. What is Eclipse and what is HANA Studio? Because from now onwards, we will do all our development only on Eclipse, not on SAP UI. We will completely move towards the Eclipse. Okay. So now many of you think, what is this Eclipse, bhai? Okay, some of you who are coming from hardcore FF background have no clue about it. Some of you might think, might listen about it, but you listen about Java only. You may think like Java is Eclipse or Eclipse is only for Java. No, Eclipse is not only for Java, but Eclipse is a development tool like any other development tool. Okay. That's why Eclipse is also known as Integrated Development Environment, which is IDE. So Eclipse IDE is a development tool like any other tools. We can do HANA development and web development both on Eclipse. Okay. So also Eclipse IDE is an open source program and is made available by adding an ADT, a web development tool, plug into the SAP system. We will see ADT in the next slide. Okay. So simply we can say, see, Eclipse is just a development tool where we can do ABAP development by installing ADT, which is ABAP development tool. Okay. Is it clear? And here we can do HANA development and ABAP development both only on Eclipse. Okay. So what is this HANA Studio? So SAP HANA Studio is a development and administration tool for working with SAP HANA. Also, HANA Studio is a modified version of Eclipse, which SAP develops. Okay. So what is this HANA Studio? HANA Studio is also a development tool, which was a modified version of Eclipse. It's just nothing new. Okay, what is HANA Studio? It's a modified version of Eclipse, which was developed by SAP. Remember, HANA Studio can also be used for HANA and ABAP development both. Even if you don't have HANA Studio, you can use Eclipse for HANA development or for ABAP development. Okay. So, is this clear that Eclipse is not Java, but it's a development tool? Biggest benefit of Eclipse is, what is Eclipse is completely free, guys. It's a free software. So, using Eclipse, we can connect to ABAP system and we can develop ABAP programs. Okay? So, basically, is it clear to you? So, Eclipse and HANA Studio, both are development tools. Okay? And Eclipse is completely free. Okay? Is it clear, guys? So, now let's move to the next question. So, what is the need? How Eclipse came into the picture? When we are having our SAP GUI, then what is the main use of this Eclipse? So if we will get back to our basics, okay. Just one second. So this is my three. If we will see our present three tier architecture. So second, this is my presentation layer. Okay. This is my application layer. Okay. And at the last, we are having our database layer. Okay. This is my database. As we know, and here we are having our SAP GUI. Okay. Unpicking race. So this is my SAP GUI. So till today, what we are doing in our company, in whatever we are doing till now, we are using SAP GUI and connecting these to ABAP server. Okay, connecting this to application layer. This is what we used to do till now. Okay, is it clear? Now, what is the need of this Eclipse? Okay, we are easily writing our other programs. This is what we are doing today from SAP UI to application layer. Okay, so now SAP is using HANA database, but now this was happening when before HANA, but now what is our database is our HANA. Okay, and it wants to connect to HANA now. Now the problem was SAP GUI cannot directly connect to HANA. Okay, SAP GUI has no support for connecting to HANA database. Okay, so from here there is no connection towards SAP from here to directly database layer. There is no connection, guys. Okay, so here we cannot connect directly. Okay, so if, so we can not connect directly to the HANA database through SAP GUI. So now what happened? SAP was looking for some tool which SAP can give you for connecting to HANA. For connecting to HANA database, SAP was searching ki ha bhai, from where can we connect to the HANA database. So for connecting to HANA, SAP was looking for it. SAP did all market research, but in the market research, the main, like the good software, good development software which everyone was using was, which one was, is that is our Eclipse only. Okay, so in the market most few development tool is Eclipse. So Eclipse is that development tool which was used most in the market by every developer, and the best practice is for Eclipse is completely free, guys. It's a free development. Okay, so this is why Eclipse, which is completely free. This is free, all free. We don't have to pay anything for this. Okay, free, right? It, Eclipse is free. So SAP, but what SAP did? How that HANA Studio came? So SAP, what he has done? SAP downloaded the complete code of Eclipse and they modified it and they name it as SAP, sorry, they name it as HANA Studio. So the use case of Eclipse, so here what is the main use case of Eclipse is to connect to the HANA database. Okay, so here from this Eclipse, here we can connect to the HANA database directly. We don't need SAP GUI, guys. Okay, then SAP evolved further. So the first benefit of Eclipse is we can do HANA development on Eclipse. Is it clear? Now, the second benefit is later on SAP. What SAP introduced after that? ABAP on HANA. And now, they wanted to support new features. So, what they did? They also enabled another powerful thing. They have enabled ABAP system to connect to the Eclipse. Okay. What they have enabled it to connect to the Eclipse. Directly we can connect to the Eclipse. Okay. So this is the second benefit where Eclipse can be directly connected to our ABAP layer. Okay. They also enabled another powerful thing. They have enabled this ABAP system to connect to the Eclipse. Now, our Eclipse is a central environment which can connect to ABAP on HANA. Okay, now we are not using SAP GUI directly, we are using Eclipse for development. Also, in this course, I will do all the development on your Eclipse. Okay, it is clear, right? This concept is clear why Eclipse came into the picture, because SAP GUI was not directly supported to the HANA database. We cannot connect to the HANA database through SAP GUI. So Eclipse came into the picture. Okay. Is it clear? What is Eclipse and HANA Studio? What is the need of Eclipse? You can write here. Then the next is, what is ADT? As we have listened with ARP, you can connect, do adapt development through ADT. What is ADT? So ADT is also a development tool for SAP NetWeaver. Okay. ADT enables us as ABAP developers to perform development tasks using the ABAP application layer capabilities in an Eclipse-based IDE. Or in the classic ABAP workbench. The documentation layer is intended for ABAP developments to work on the open Eclipse platform. Okay. Is it clear everything, guys? Eclipse, what is ADT, what is our HANA Studio? Now let's start. How can we download the Eclipse and how can we connect this to the ABAP system? Okay, so before that, there is some prerequisites. Okay. What are these? First is, what is first is our computer. Second. Yeah, and our computer must have installed JDK. Okay, so for checking JDK, just one second. So for checking the JDK, how can we check like our system is having JDK or not? So for this, okay, we will go to the command prompt. Okay, we will write here Java, then we will write here version. Our system is not having JDK downloaded. So how can we download this JDK? We'll go to our browser. We'll go here. JDK download. Okay. We will go there. We go to the Java download. We'll, where is that? Yeah, here we go to Windows. And we can download it, okay? Just click on this installer. Our download will start, okay? Let's wait for it downloading, okay? So here you can see, and this our downloaded. Now we'll double click here, we will install it. Go to next, okay? So it will start installing the Java and Rover system. Okay. So look, our Java is downloaded, JDK is downloaded for the system. Now we will go to the where this one is downloaded. Okay. Here, now it has downloaded. We will go to the path of the JDK where we have downloaded this. Here, program files, go to the here, JDK, okay. We will go there. Okay, what we will do, we will copy this path. Okay, we will go to the inside bin. We will copy this path. Okay, and let's copy this path and now go to edit environment system, environment variables. So there, environment variables. Go here, double click on path. Okay. Click on new, paste the path. Okay. Copy it. Okay. 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 Okay, go to CMD again. रेस्ट वाली खाई जाए सके समय ना। गाइस दे सक्सेसफुली इंस्टॉल्ड ओवर जावा जेडीके एंड ओवर सिस्टम। ओके दिस क्लियर नाउ यू गो बैक। सो वी हैव डन आवर फर्स्ट कंप्लीटेड दिस फर्स्ट स्टेप। ओके गो बैक। व्हाट इज द सेकंड ऑप्शन इज लेट मी गो टू द सेकंड ऑप्शन। तो नाउ गाइस वी हैव ऑलरेडी इंस्टॉल्ड दिस जावा जेडीके इनटू आवर सिस्टम। नाउ द सेकंड प्री रिक्वेस्ट फॉर यूजिंग एपैप ऑन हाना इज वी शुड बी हैविंग विंडोज डॉट नेट एनवायरनमेंट। ओके इनटू आवर सिस्टम। तो फॉर दिस वी कैन गो टू अवर ब्राउजर। सेकंड इस इज माय स्क्रीन अगेन। So from here we can download our can copy paste this link and once again you can download it from here. Okay. We will go there and here you can see you can download it from anywhere as per our system. Okay. Now our download will start and it will be downloaded. Now the third request is we will go there. Third request is we should be having SAP GUI already installed into our system. SAP GUI. Okay. SAP GUI you might or have already it, or you can also download it from any service marketplace. That's GUI, SAP GUI part. Okay. And already you can download Windows.NET 3.1 version from here. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. So now this is the prerequisite. So our main course is for what we have to learn. We have to download for our main course. First is we have to download the Eclipse. And the second we have to download the ADT. Firstly, we have to download this Eclipse. So, for downloading the Eclipse, you can go again to our browser. One second. We can again go to our browser. And, here you can see you can download our Eclipse from here. Okay, you can copy this link and I will share this document with all of you. Okay, you can download it from here. Also, you for this in Microsoft environment, you can also download it from here. Okay, and for now you can download Eclipse from here. Click here, it will navigate you to the Eclipse platform. Here, click on Windows. Now our download will start. Okay. So let's wait till our download will start. Look, our Eclipse is downloaded. Double click here. Okay. Our Eclipse will start. Let's wait. Click on Eclipse ID, click on install. Our install will start. Okay, let's wait. It will. Let's wait. It's installed. Now click on launch. Eclipse will start. Okay, so I pasted this Eclipse here also. You can download it from here. Okay. That's for it. So it's asking for workplace, okay? So in workplace is asking for selecting the directory. Here, what is this? Where you want to put your files, okay? When you run Eclipse, it will create some files. So workplace is just nothing but a folder where Eclipse will keep its files. This is, okay, defined. Now click on launch. Or Eclipse will start, okay? Let's wait for this. Look, our Eclipse got started. Look, guys, here you can see if you will go to file new, we can't see any app over here. Now you will say, sir, if we will use it for APAP. But it's not like if you have only installed Eclipse, then you will start developing your web course over here. Firstly, only you have just installed the Eclipse. Okay, you will not see any option here. Or so here you can see only basic Eclipse. Okay, so it's like take it as a for example, whenever we go to market and we buy any new laptop or mobile phone, so it's only like no mobile, it's completely new. So we have to install our own custom. We have to install our custom apps. Custom apps means the apps which we need. For example, we will download WhatsApp, we will download this social media apps, we will install Drive, we will all of these things we have to do into our new laptop. It's Eclipse is also the same. Take it as a new laptop or new mobile phone where you have to make it feasible for your work. So what is our feasibility over here? We need to make it work as an APAP for us where we can write our codes. Okay. So for this, we have to install the ADT. Okay. How can we install the ADT? One second. This. For ADT, okay. So for ADT, we will go to one second. We'll go to help, we'll go to Estonian software. So here we can, from here we have to download our ADT. Okay, for downloading the ADT, paste this link. Okay. Click on enter. It will find. So guys, our ADT app development tool is here. That's what we need. That's actually what we need. Okay. Inside this, we'll select only this checkbox. Inside this, you can see a web business object tools, web connectivity and integration developments. All of these from we will install this ADT. Okay. This is same applied to Ana Studio also. Even Ana Studio can be used for developing ABAP programs. Now install this ADT. Okay. Here we just have to pass our URL, okay, which I have attached with this PDF, file also, and click on enter. You will get this. Okay. Just check ABAP development tools checkbox. Now click on next. It will do all its processing. Okay. Now just wait, like to install it. Now click on next. Okay. It will take some time. Okay. So that's why. Now click on next again. I accept the terms and click on finish. Okay. This is how we can install the ADT over here. Okay. Is this clear? You can see this. Okay. This is our Eclipse. Now, what we have to do, and also this is completely free, but remember, server is not free. As I told you, we need server also. Okay. Trust this. Okay. Select. Then select all. Trust selected. Okay. I also told you that we need HANA server also, but this is not free. Okay. You need to buy it from somewhere. You can Google it or you can ask from your company, like, we need HANA. I want to do HANA practice. You can ask from company. They may have this HANA server, or you can Google it. Some vendors may provide it to you. Okay. But they will charge it for you. Okay. And that server is not free. Okay. Now, How can we connect Eclipse to server now? Okay. So it's completely now we have to restart it. Okay. We have to restart the software. Again, I will again open this Eclipse IDE. It will get a shortcut on our. Okay. Again, let's start it. Again, it will ask us for this workplace and we will click on it. Okay. Click on launch. Once it was. I think it's already running somewhere. Oops. Okay, it's got started. Okay. Now we can, how can we connect this? Okay. For this, once again, go to project, go to Windows, go to perspective, go to open perspective, then go to other. So guys, please restart your system once. Only then you can able to see this app over here. And now what we will do, we will just directly go there and we will click on, once again. Yeah, we will go to Windows, then we will go to perspective, open. So what we need to do over here, we need to connect to ABAP server. Still, we are not connected to ABAP server now. We need to connect this to our ABAP server. Okay. As I told you, SAP is not free. Okay. This one, SAP server is not free. Only this Eclipse is free and this ABAP is free. Here you can see if we will go to file. Okay. Eclipse. One second. Let me put this. Here you can see SAP. This is my HANA server. This is not free. You need to buy this. From, like, you can Google it or you can ask it from your company, hey, why, please provide me any server for my practice. Okay. Or you can buy from outside vendors. You can do this. Okay. So now we need to connect. It's not like we have downloaded Eclipse. We have downloaded this. We have downloaded this AGT and we have SAP server. But now we need to connect our Eclipse to the SAP server. For this, go to Windows, go to perspective, go to open perspective, then go to others. Okay. Here, as you can see, ABAP. Finally, we have installed our ABAP 880 to this Eclipse. Now we can use this. Okay. Now click on open. Okay. So if we will go to file, what will you do? Here you can see file, new, ABAP project. It's there, guys. We can create our project. We can create a web class. We can create interface. We can create package. We can create everything whatever we need. We can create from there. Is it clear? Okay. Remember this. To choose this only. First we choose this. Go to Windows. Go to perspective. Go to open perspective. And then click on other. Here you can click on ABAP. Then click on open. This is what you need to do this. Okay. Is it clear, guys? Here you can see if you go to file, new, here you can see the ABAP project. What is this ABAP project? Okay. What is this? Okay. Here you can see this ABAP project. It's nothing. Okay. But handler to an SAP server who connects with ABAP server. Okay. Creating ABAP project is like connecting to ABAP server. So your ABAP server is SAP UI. Your ABAP server, ABAP HANA server in SAP GUI. Okay. Okay. Please add or firstly add this HANA server to your SAP GUI. Okay. Here, what we will do, we will go to file, we will go to new, we will go to ABAP project. Okay. Look, guys, the servers, whichever are there into my SAP GUI, all of those servers, it will pick here. Okay. This is clear. So here I have these two as ECC servers. And this middle one is my HANA server. So if I will try to connect this ECC server, it will not allow us to connect. Only HANA server we can connect. Click on next, select this, then I will click on next. Is it clear? Okay, then click on next, next. It will ask some detail. It will not ask any details. Directly it will tell the details from backend, okay? Now give the client here. Okay. These all details will be provided to you from the vendor, from wherever you will buy this. Okay. It's not like it's same details for everyone. You can buy. From wherever you will buy, you can get these books. Okay. I will enter my username. I will enter my password. Okay. Click on next. Okay. There is some issue. One second, guys. Let me do it again. File. Select next. Next. I will give the client number there. Enter the client there. Enter the username. Enter the password. One second. Okay, and click on next. Alright, guys, let me see this code. This is okay. Guys, if you are getting this type of error, please install this VS Code into your system. At that time, you will be able to use. No error will come. Okay, so we will go to file again. New ABAP project, select our server. Okay. Give the client number, give the username, give the password. So finally, we are connected to our web system. Okay. If you will go to anywhere. Okay. We can create our new project from here. ABAP is there. We can create any class, any cloud project, anything, whatever we want to create, we can create it from here. Okay. We'll go here, next. It will ask us for any program name. For example, it will give a Z demo program. Okay. Training. It will ask us for package. We will give any package there. Select any package, next, and we will click on training. Okay. This is second, it will take some time. This is how we used to create any program ever there. Okay. One second, where is it opening? We go there. अबे यहाँ क्यों मिला? Guys, and this screen will open. Okay, here you can see our connection is there. Inside this, if you will go, and you can see our objects as of now, local objects. Okay, favorite package, no, nothing is there. Okay. Everything it will pick over there. Here you can see the dictionary, our tables name over there. Everything, data elements, whatever you see in the SE11, sorry, in the SAP GUI, you can see over there. Okay. Is it fine? So if we will move next towards from here, what are the benefits of using SAP ABAP on HANA? Okay, using have to develop. So guys, if you are getting that type of error, please, please install this VS Code into your system, okay? So let's give the password here. Click on finish, or you can click on next. So here you can see, this is the connection which is made over here, okay? Same as the backend system, okay? HANA server is there. So this is my S4D system. This is how we can connect our Eclipse to the server, SAP GUI, okay? So first step is go to perspective, okay? Go to window, go to perspective, go to open perspective, click on other, then select ABAP there, then click on open, then go to file, then go to new, Then click on new project. Okay. And then you will be able to create the new project. New project means you can create a new project over there. Okay, this is fine. Here you can see it will fetch all the details which is there in the backend system. Okay. Source code, programs it can fetch. For example, this is any program. So it will look like the same. Okay. This is any report. Okay. So this is the basic of this Eclipse. So is it clear? So what are the prerequisites? I will tell you again. Firstly, we have to download the JLDK system. I will attach the link over there. We will save this file to you. Okay. Then we have to do this. Install this VS Code, and we need SAP GUI. Okay. From where you can get this SAP GUI? You can ask your company, or you can do Google, or there some vendors may provide you this connection list. But buy that HANA server link over there. Okay. Then in main course, you need Eclipse. Okay. And then you need ADT. After installing Eclipse, then there we have to install new software, which is ADT, App Development Tool. So is it clear everywhere? Everyone clear? Okay. Let's play. Okay. One second, guys. So then the main question everyone may be thinking, why do we use Eclipse when we are already having that SAP GUI? As I told you there, here we don't have any support for SAP GUI through which we can directly connect to HANA database. Okay. So that's why we came across with the Eclipse. So now we will discuss what are the main features. Like, why do we use Eclipse? So first, as you can see here, is better code management in the Eclipse. Okay. Then we have integration with other tools, better support for object-oriented program. Okay. And let me think, are you still using SCAT? Okay. Believe me, it's a time to switch to Eclipse ADT, the modern, versatile and featured pack IDE. Okay. And Eclipse is absolutely free. That's been taking the app development world by you. Okay. When it comes to SAP development, SCAT has been a go-to tool for years. Like, for example, if I log into the backend system, 1 second. Okay, this is my backend system. Okay, spoke out. Let me log in again. So this is my basic backend system, which hope everyone, all of you are using this, okay? Everyone know this app workbench here, application function group, function module, you can create all those things from here. Okay, so if I will go back to the there, 1 second. Okay. So I know that it can be hard to convince people to switch to a new tool, especially when they have been using same, when what we were using previously only SAP UI. So without further ado, here are some reasons. Okay, these are some reasons due for which we have to move to Eclipse. Okay, is it fine? So what is this better code management? With Eclipse ADT, we can integrate with version control systems like Git. We have GitHub. They are making it easier to keep track of changes to your code and collaborate with other developers. Plus, with features like code formatting and debugging tools, you will be able to write better code and catch errors before they become a problem. For example, if you will, I will show you in Eclipse, like if you are doing some error will be there, then immediately it will tell us, hey, this is the error, please fix it. But yeah, if I will show you, just 1 second. This is my inclusive system, okay? So what happened? For example, is it fine? Dash is there if I will write 1 there, okay? So as soon as I will change this, what it will give to my the error. Okay. The field dashed 1 is unknown, but there is a field with dash. Okay. So that's how this is the main use better code management over there. For example, but if we are doing the same in our backend system, if I will go there. Okay. If I will go there and if I will change anything over, okay. We are already in change mode there. If I will go. Okay. If I will go there in the backend system, 1 second, let me put this. Okay. Here, if I will go to the change mode, here you can see if I will make the same thing as 1. Will it suggest us? Hey, this is wrong? No. Then it will tell us when we will complete this and whenever we will click on check button, only then it will tell us, hey, bhai, this is not correct. Okay, please change this. So, but here in the front end, what it happens, as soon as we will change it, it will give us the error, hey, please change this. Okay, is it clear, everyone? We activate this, save, check, activate. Okay, so this is the good feature in Eclipse over there. Okay, is it clear? Now let's go back. Okay, this is also having integration with other tools. What does this mean? Like now we need to integrate with external systems like SAP HANA or external databases. No problem. Eclipse ADT has you covered. Okay, everything. It also supports integration with task management tools like Jira, making it easy to track tasks and manage project activities. Okay, then we have better support and better support for object-oriented programming. Okay, if we are using object-oriented programming in our Ada project, and you should be, Eclipse ADT provides better support for it than AVAP Workbench or than our SE38. With features like inheritance, encapsulation, and polymorphism, you will be able to write more maintainable and extensible codes. Okay, clear guys? It also supports with our, okay, this you can work with development, quality, production simultaneously. It's having fast search and navigation skills. Okay, then only this Eclipse will support CDS view, MDP. Okay, CDS views like in HANA are very important feature of modern web development. Okay, and obviously Eclipse ADT provides full support for them. With Eclipse ADT, you can easily create and manage CDS views, making it easier to write efficient and maintainable code. But you cannot edit the CDS views in the SAP GUI. Okay. We will discuss about this, what is the CDS view, what is this AMDPs, okay? We'll see your SQL scripts also. All of this we will discuss in our coming up sessions, okay? Is it clear, guys? And we have only software which fully supports SAP ABAP on HANA and ABAP on Cloud. Only this software, Eclipse, will fully support this ABAP on HANA and ABAP on Cloud. Inside this, we are having some code templates. For example, if you are going to create any CDS view, it will give me some code templates. Hey, do you want to use this? We have this template. Okay, it's also free. It's easy to configure in any laptop. And it's all obviously it's not having any setup cost. Okay, everything is clear, guys. Now, if the last topic of this class, we will move to the what are the Qt shortcuts? Like, in backend, we have seen in SE38 for save control S, okay, control F2, control F3, control D for copying the same line, control O for go to any line. So in Eclipse also, we are having some code shortcuts. So some of them are control Shift A. This is for open development of them. Okay. So let me go back to the Eclipse. Okay. So first, shortcut what we are having is control shift A, open any development object. What does this mean? Control shift A, if I will press, So here for any table or anything, whatever the name, any table, any program name, whatever we will give, it will test. For example, I will give the table name as Mara. Okay. So it has tested the Mara table. Okay. I will click on okay. It will open a new tab. Here you can see this is my Mara table. Okay. So what is this? If you want to open any program, Control Shift A. 1 second. 1 second, guys. Okay, guys. So if we want to open any program name, we will give the any program name. For example, I will give this program name. This is my program. Click on OK. Then it will open my program. So is it clear? First shortcut is open any development object. We can press Control Shift A. It will open my any object, development object. Okay. Then if you want to see where you wish, then we can click on Control Shift G. If we want to see where this program is used, I will click on Control Shift G. It will give me the value list. Okay. So here in backend, if I will show you, here we have this option as where you list. Okay. If you will click here, look for like this program is not used anywhere. If you will go there and for this Mara table, and if you will click on Control Shift G, it will fetch the where you list of this table. Okay. If you will go to SE11 here in the backend, this is my value list. Oh, sorry. Look, wherever this program is used, it will fetch. Okay. You'll find where your second shortcut is value list. Okay. Control Shift G. What is this cube outline? Control O. Control O is for cube outline. If you will go there, purge this up from here. Okay. Control O. For example, this is my program. Okay. If you want to see all over the outline of this program, what you will do? You will press Control O. Look, all these variables I created. Okay. These tables I've used over there. SK1, LSK1, CSKS. All these variables I've declared here. So this is what this will give the overall outline of this program. Okay. Control O. Okay. Control O is clear. Control F2 is same for syntax check. Control F3 for activate. Control F2 is for syntax check. This is a button of check. Okay. Control F2. This is a button of activating the program. Okay. And what is this? This is a button for activating all these inactive objects inside this. Okay. Cancel this. Same. If you want to open SAP GUI here only, what we will do? We can press Control 6. It will open the SAP GUI over there. Okay. So you can use SAP GUI here. If you want to go to any code from here only, go to SE11. Same. Whatever we was using in the backend, same process we can use here. Okay. Clear. Then we have Control Shift 10 for any new development object. We will go there. Let's press Control Shift 10. Okay. If you want to create any project over there, we can click there. Okay. Okay. We want to create any dictionary, web type group, web program. We want to create any. Okay. Web in group, function module, function group, interface, whatever we want to create. If we want to create any new object, we can press Control Shift 10. Okay. So how to add or remove any comment? Okay. For example, I want to comment this. Second. Okay. One second, guys. It's not responding. Just wait one second. If you want to comment any line, we will click on Control Shift. Smaller button, you want to uncomment, Control Shift greater button. Okay, they clear. And one more option is there, Control 7. We can press Control 7. Here we will press Control 7, it will uncomment. It will again press Control 7, it will comment the line. Okay, Control 7 is also there. 5 there as control plus 7 plus use plus 1 fan, F1 is for indent, indent is like and session. Okay, shift plus F1 indent, for example, this is my backend. If we will click on pattern, oh sorry, little green in the backend, it will work the same. And the last is our control D. If you delete the selected line, you want to delete this line, and you click on control D, it will directly delete the whole line. Okay, then at the last, we have to, if you want to move any line up or down, then we have alt up and down. What we can do here, if you want to move this line up, what we will do, click on alt and up and click on down. Whatever you to do, you can test this. Save, check. I will activate this program. Okay, if you want to execute this, we can click there. Okay, run as a web application. It will bring me the fetch output. Okay, as this program is having some output screen, selection screen, it will go there. If I will go run this program, or we can right click there, run as a web application. Firstly, let's activate this. Okay, activate this, run as app. Maybe app application once again. Okay, you can see this is my output. For example, 1, 2, 3. It will be print. Okay, this is the output screen over there. So all of these things are clear, guys. This quick shortcuts, this one features, and what are the like? How can we download this Eclipse? This is the main part of this session. Okay. Hope everything is clear, guys. Yeah. Thank you so much. See you in the next session. Thank you.